So how did flight evolve in these dinosaurs? Welcome to the Natural History of Dinosaurs. My name is Benjamin Brugger. I'm a paleontologist teaching at Utah State University in the heart of Utah's dinosaur country in Vernal. So I thought I would add a few comments on a very complex topic on the origin of flight in dinosaurs and the origin of birds. One of the things that I think strikes people as strange is that these maniraptor and dinosaurs like Velociraptor, Microraptor, Utah Raptor, Deinonychus, all these maniraptor and theropod dinosaurs, they all appear to have had these really long, more advanced feathers extending from their arms. And the discovery recently of the membraned maniraptor and dinosaur Yi Qi in the late Jurassic sort of adds to this strangeness of these advanced theropods with these weird small wing-like structures, yet appearing to lack the ability to really flap those wings with a restricted tendon for the supracorticoideus muscle that's eventually developed in birds. So what gives? I mean, were these gliding dinosaurs, or did they run and jump into the air for short bursts if they could not fly for these long distances and weren't able to do the flapping, the active flapping that we only see in birds? Now, the origin of birds has been classically viewed as either a gliding down from the trees to powered flight, you know, eventually flapping, or running and jumping up toward powered flight. And the truth is that many of these winged dinosaurs likely did a bit of both, that these primitive wings allowed them to access perches, increase their speed, and extend the distances that they could glide. Some may have lived in dense forests where gliding would be an advantage, but remember that the hip socket in the saurischian dinosaurs restricted some of the abduction or extension away from the body of the femur. So climbing was fairly restricted in these groups of the ones that we actually have good hips fossilized of. What many people hypothesize is that flight arose from a inclination to climb steep slopes and various obstacles that they would encounter. These little proto-wings gave them a boost. Now, my chickens do this when the neighbor's dog gets into the backyard. They use their wings to hop up onto the fence or up onto the roof of the house where the dog can't jump up and get them. So the origin of flight may have been something beyond the gliding and running and jumping idea. It likely was that they used these proto-wings to chase prey and to escape from being eaten themselves. Having a little extra flight in a jump or a glide would be an advantage, even without long-distance flight like we see in modern birds. All right, be sure to compare and contrast these ideas and the possibility that flight may have arose from a combination of gliding and running and jumping behaviors.